Hi there, Jamie Keat here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today, I want to give you seven quick tips that you may not know about in Google Drive. So tip number one is just about customizing the look of your folders inside Google Drive. Now, a lot of you may already just color your folders by simply right-clicking on them and change a color, like so, but you can also add emojis like these. So it's really quick to do. I have a different website open here, and I'm just going to flip over to a tab. And on this website, you can hover over these and copy from these and go back over to your Google Drive. And as soon as you right click and you go to rename, you can just simply paste in Control V, your whatever you took right from there and hit okay. And then you have it here. Now, a different way I like to do this a little bit quicker is actually going to the extension and just go ahead and add this to Chrome. And I'll put the link down to this in the description down below. But if I go ahead and add this description here, you can see it opens the website. But what I'm gonna do is just pin it right here. So I'm gonna go here, you can see that I've added it. I'm just gonna go ahead and pin it up top so you can see that little heart. Go over to my Google Drive. Now, at any time, I can go up to this, click on this heart, and I can do a search. So if I was looking for something like expenses or money, you can see if I wanted to change from what I have, I can go ahead and copy this, go down to here, right click, just hit rename, delete this one emoji I have, and paste the other one in, and I've made the change. So very simple to change the look of your folders inside Google Drive. So for tip number two, did you know you could open up a PDF and edit it inside Google Drive? Now, how you do this is I have this report here, the science report. It's just a PDF. I want to be able to edit it. You can see if I double click on it, it is a PDF just like this. Now, I can do this in a couple different ways. I can open with Google Docs here. And I'm just going to click off. I'm going to right click on this and just go to open with Google Docs here. It's the same thing, but I just want to show you those two places. When you have a PDF that's, you know, typed, written, and it's been turned into a PDF, Google Drive can go through and turn it into the exact looking PDF, but now in Google Docs, you can go through and make any edits to this. And remember, inside Google Docs, if you wanted it back to a PDF at the end, you can go ahead and go File, Download, and you can download it as a PDF if that's the way you want to keep it when you share it back out. So that's tip number two. Tip number three is about using the OCR built into Google Drive, so optical character recognition. Now, I just took this picture of a short paragraph with my phone and uploaded it to Google Drive. Same thing, if I right click on this and go open with Google Docs, it will go through and read the characters and turn it into text inside Google Docs. So you can see it opened up. You can see how everything is kind of was curved and how I quickly just took the picture, but the text is inside here and it takes the picture and leaves it up above. Now, it's not always perfect when it does this. And if you have a large page with a lot of text, it can take a bit of time to process this, but it's kind of a cool thing if you just want to quickly turn something into text from a picture. Now, at any time, if you go back to your Google Drive, you can see it creates Google Docs inside your Google Drive. So here is what was just created. And even in my last example that I just showed, it creates that science report in a Google Doc, but still keeps the original PDF as well. Okay, so now for tip number four, I just want to show you how quickly you can open up the Google Apps with typing this and with them. So if I go and type doc.new like this, it will open up a new doc just like this. If I go and type slides.new and go ahead, it will open a new one. If I type sheets.new, it will open it up. If I type forms.new, it's going to open it up. If I go ahead and type sites.new, it's going to open up a new Google Sites. So really quick access just by typing the app name, then putting the .new after it. So give that a try. So, did you know you could force a copy for somebody? Because sometimes you send them a view-only doc or sheet or slide, and you want them to make a copy. They might not know how to do that, or it just slows down the process. But you can force it automatically to happen, and this is how it works. So, if I go ahead and open this science report that I created from the PDF earlier, just the Google Doc, because this will work with docs and sheets and slides. If I open this up. If you take a look at the URL across here, if I just change this last word here where it says edit, if I just put the word copy in here like this, I'm just going to go ahead and select the whole thing now and Control C, and I'm going to put it in here. So just an open doc. So what can happen at this point if I put it in a different document or maybe I email them this link? When they click on this, if they go ahead and open, it forces a copy. So I again make a copy. It eliminates that step of them having to go up to file and make a copy because sometimes they just don't understand that part. And this works with others, as I mentioned. So if I open up a Google Slides on this and I just look across the URL at the end and I can highlight this like this and type the word copy. And what I'm going to do is I'll just right click and copy this time and open a new tab. And I'm just Control V, paste it in. And you can see force that, make a copy, eliminate that step, just make it easier so that you know that they get their own copy for them. So tip number seven is about shortcuts, and it's in a couple different ways. So the first one, I find it really powerful to be able to put shortcuts to different documents you have inside your Google Drive without having to copy it all over the place. If we right click on this document right here and take a look, it says add shortcut to Drive. I'm going to hover over this shortcuts link to the original, allowing an item to appear in more than one location. So it's just going to connect it to it. So if I go ahead and select this, you can see where do I want it to be, and then I would pick my folder. So if I go ahead, go down, I'll put it into shortcut folder number one, add shortcut. Now I'm going to go into this shortcut folder that I created here. And you can see it. So if I take a look at it, you can see the little shortcut symbol here that it's not the original. It's a shortcut that will connect me to the original. I can go ahead and I can remove it from here if you'd want. I'm going to go back to my Google Drive here. I want to show you even a faster way to do this, and I'm going to use shortcut folder number two. If I just click and go to drag it to shortcut folder number two, as soon as I hold Control down on my keyboard here and drop it in, take a look what happened here. So if I go log in, or if I just open that folder now, it created that shortcut here. So if I go back one more time, notice as soon as I start dragging, I'm dragging and hold down Control, and I get that little symbol that it's going to be a shortcut added to it. So then you can just bring it into any folder, and it will add it there. Now, the last thing I want to end you with is more shortcuts. You can take a look. These can speed you up a lot when working inside Google Drive or any apps. But if you click on the settings up top here and go to keyboard shortcuts. Take a look at all the different ways you can manage your Google Drive that can speed you up. You can search through different things from uploading to creating to application. There's lots of different things, and maybe you'll find that one that you know that you tend to use a lot, and using just that one can save you so much time. So I hope you like these tips today with Google Drive, these seven tips that maybe you did know about them, maybe you didn't, but hopefully I helped you out a bit with some of them, gave you some ideas. Let me know of some great tips maybe you're using with Google Drive. Just write them down in the comments, and I can create a different video about some of the ones I learned from you too. So thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.